Hi, this is Angela, Danceable Thoughts. This is Hear It Tonight and Use It Tomorrow. This is a mid-February edition. This is a unique format. This is a narrated PowerPoint. I hope that you'll forgive the lack of sophistication in my tools, but I have some really important information I want to convey to you. I feel very passionate about. My subject for you this evening is your own best judgment. And I'm hoping that by using a danceable thoughts point of view with a growth mindset, that you'll evaluate your day at contest, not just from the point of view of a score on a score sheet, but from the entire continuum of the experience. I'm really enjoying looking at all the social media posts of your teams and the pictures of smiling children holding trophies and banners. I know that you walked away from contest with some verbal critiques, some score sheets with some numbers on them. I want to remind you those are very much the tangible parts of contest, but that isn't the sum total of your experiences. So let's talk about being competitive. I love competition. There's no reason for me to even hide that. I'd be remiss if I didn't admit it. But I want you to play a little mental game with me. Put yourself back in your competition venue, whether you're in an auditorium or you are in a gym. And I want you to think about all those people that were in that space with you, the judges, the general audience, your own particular fan base, your competitors, and I want you to think about your performers on the floor. Their opinions all matter to the overall evaluation of those moments in performance. At any given, section of the performance, one group's opinions probably matter more than the others. And when you start the list with the judges, you're at a competition. Of course, you're working to earn a score from those judges, but I want you to think about what you want them to see and what you want them to evaluate. I hope you'll approach your choreography with, I'm going to call it the Olympic compulsory mindset, that there are certain skills that you want them to see and you want them to evaluate. So when you're preparing your team, you're preparing those skills. I also want you to think about the creative aspects that you are infusing into the performance, and you're giving those judges an opportunity to offer a subjective opinion about how successfully your choreography and your performers are communicating that idea. So the opinions of your judges, of course, they're paramount to the process, but they aren't the sole inhabitants of that space. You've got a general audience who their energy and their response helps fuel the energy and excitement that your performers feel. That's the hooping and the hollering and the clapping and the woo-hoos. It makes for a complete experience, performer and audience. That includes your fan base, and they are doubly invested. They are invested on an individual level for their particular performer on your team that they've come to see. You want them to be excited and appreciate the effort that individual student has put towards the total goal of your group. And you want them to be invested in the achievement of your program altogether, because they are the ones that have seen the hard side of it. They've gotten their child back and forth to your practice, or they've given up time with their child so your child can be at their practice. So you hope that their opinions matter. And so you take that into consideration as well when you're thinking about how you prepare the total package that is your team at performance. You think about the other competitors, and I don't mean that you just go in there thinking about how you rank against them, and you hope that you can establish a mindset in your students and that other directors will do the same, that there's a reciprocal feeling of respect and support for other performers. That's something you have to cultivate and let your students understand that, yes, those kids are going to be in there, and some of them may not be quite as enthusiastic because they're caught up in the competitive aspect. But one of the greatest gifts that you can plant in your kid's mind is learning to appreciate the competition no matter how difficult it is, because from that level of competition, it will inspire growth in your students. And speaking of your students, let's talk about their opinions. How do they feel on the performance floor? Are they excited? Are they proud? Are they overcoming their own anxieties about performing? Their opinions of the experience matter. Now, at any given moment, again, this list is going to shift what's on the top and what's down. Within the own moments of the choreography, there are some moments that are for the judges, and there are some for your home fan base. There are some that are for you. And that's the next slide. What about your opinion? When you think about your students' performance, don't cut yourself short in only evaluating the technical aspects, the precision aspects. In other words, don't stop at the score sheet. You shouldn't stop at the score sheet, because the score sheet evaluates an increment of time. You, I hope, are evaluating your performances with that idea of that growth mindset, as it's part of a continuum. After all, who is better than you to evaluate the performances and the performers that you brought to this moment? The judges see them there in 5-minute increments. You've seen them all year long. And I'm speaking to you as a person who does critiques and does judging, and I teach people to know that when you're out there, you have one shot at it, that you've got to lay it all out there, and you've got to perform, and you got to do it, be done with it, and move on. That's what the judges are evaluating. That's what the casual observer in the audience is observing and evaluating. What I hope you're evaluating is the whole process. So the truth is this, that the roots of your group's experiences were planted by you long before you ever got to the contest site. And I use the image of tulips here because tulips grow from bulbs. And while I am no horticulture specialist, I want you to think about how a tulip grows, that the bulb is tightly compact and it shoots roots down, and then the blossom goes up. The blossom first is closed, and then it opens out. And while that all sounds very poetic, that is your year. That is your program. From year to year, a bulb is planted and it grows, and then you bring it out and you process it, and then you replant it each year. So I want you to keep in mind, again, that growth mentality of how you move from experience to experience as part of the continuum. I want you to think about the lens in which you look at your students. You'll be able to use every part of the experience to build towards the next goal. Whether that next goal is preparing for contest this upcoming weekend, or maybe you're going to be on a break and don't have a performance for a while, you can look through the entire experience and evaluate it from lenses of your choice. And I suggest things like I used earlier this week, I did a find five skills that you want to work on. In a previous Danceable Thoughts session, I talked about the whole contest day, about how your kids are in the warm-up area, in their preparation steps. So you choose the lens in which you want to evaluate it. What I'm asking you to do is step away from the easy to go to score sheet mentality and evaluate the whole process. You can identify the areas which need improvement and where real accomplishments are being realized. See those judges, they will see that moment in time. They'll know whether someone hit that mark in the spacing. They'll know if the timing was right on a leap, or they'll know if the movement was technically executed correctly. Those are accomplishments in isolated capsules. Where the real accomplishments are going to be realized are when you look and think through where you started with a particular student and where they've come to, or where you as a director started in the process and what things you did differently this contest season that enhanced your experience. You are the best qualified to determine which achievements need to be awarded. Of course, you just sat through an award ceremony where somebody got a technique award and somebody got a precision award and somebody got a wow award, and there was a winner's circle and a honor this and honor that. Those are the things that people outside of your immediate control chose to acknowledge. I hope that you will figure out what you really need to acknowledge for your group, and you'll find an opportunity to call attention to that, that you'll find time to not necessarily just reward the best soloist of your group, but the best team player. Many of you already do this on a regular basis. Maybe you give out beads, maybe you give out certain pins or certificates. You think of Spirit Girl of the Week or Dancer of the Week. Some of you go to a daily basis. Keep that going, and don't forget to look at the overall of your contest season. Maybe you do it in a fun, silly celebration way, or maybe you have a heart-to-heart moment with your team, circle up and talk about them. But don't forget that there are some achievements that you can be the one that acknowledges in your setting of your own team. So whether you have just started competing or your contest season has concluded for this year, message to you is that your own best judgment is the starting point for the next rehearsal. Whether that rehearsal is tomorrow morning, later on this week, or you're taking a break and it will be for the next big performance you have coming up for spring show or competitions of different natures. I hope that you will keep that growth mindset always in play, and you'll use the opportunity to see competition not as an isolated event, but as a point on the continuum. So those are your danceable thoughts. See you soon. Look forward to talking to you in the future.